resident of Transformation House. Came in there about 13 months ago. I was battling with alcohol and drugs. Had a 3.6 size tumor of cancer on my liver, cirrhosis and hepatitis C as well. A lot of stomach problems that had stomach bleeding. Was pretty much on last legs when I met Pastor Gary Parrish Jr. and he picked me up and brought me into Transformation House, and that began a year of total transformation. My view of God at the time, I believed that God was alive. I just didn't know how in particular to worship Him, how to accept Him in my life and let Him make the changes in my life. I've since learned how to embrace His love and have it work through me and for me. I was raised in a home with what I call heavy social drinkers, a lot of entertaining and things centered around alcohol. I was bartending parties, you know, parents' parties and business type of gatherings where business was being conducted but in a social atmosphere. So I was probably bartending from the time I was 14, so I got very used to drinking at an early age. Later in teen years, I graduated high school in 1970, so back in those days drugs became prevalent, so I started experimenting with drugs, and alcohol was always my first choice, my drug of choice, as they say. But the once I was drinking, any other drugs that were offered were partaken of. So I developed a lot of habits of different types of drugs along with the alcohol. My daughter is a young woman, and she's had a hard time with the relapses and the lies. You know, you lie, you tell somebody you're not really using, and you are. I have a son, a young son, he's 19. My daughter's 33, and both have had a hard time dealing with me in the last couple of 3 years when things got really bad again. I've had divorces, I've, you know, lost jobs. It's just a series of really doom and gloom, basically. It's a series of unfortunate events, and for me, unfortunately, I always thought, well, I'm not hurting anybody. This is something I'm doing. But the repercussions are immense. But we are reconciled. The Lord has put those children back in my life, and they're doing well. We're in communication. She just called me before this taping to let me know she's doing well. She has a sick aunt in California. I've been praying for her, and the family wanted to get on the phone and say hi to me, and so I told them I'd call them back after the interview. Well, I had been to AA, I'd been to inpatient treatments. I did quit for an extended period, about 16, 17 years. I was working as a certified court interpreter in the courts in Spanish and English. And I tried going to different churches and trying to stay clean and sober. But after that time, I went through a series of personal problems, and I wasn't equipped to deal with them, so I went back to the choice of the drugs. That has a tendency to drown out problems that we're having, or I was having at the time. You know, my father passed away, I had gone through a bad divorce, I had adopted some children, and then I wasn't seeing them, and it was just a lot of family issues, personal issues, and I turned to the alcohol again for consolation. And so that led me over the next almost 10 years until I was physically deteriorated to the point that Pastor Gary found me and brought me in Transformation House and literally turned it all around for me. So yeah, it's real easy to fall back on crutch, which is what I consider the alcohol and the drugs, is a crutch to get us through things in life we don't want to deal with, rather than turning to God and letting Jesus, the healer and the redeemer and the person to reconcile us, to make us whole again. We turn to the things of the world, and that's what I always did until I found the Lord and was saved. I remember last year I was at the Serve fundraiser, and we were three of us on the stage. We had just lost one member, Ray Lucio to, he passed on physical problems, but he had accepted the Lord, and he was very quickly accepted the Lord in the first week he was in the program, and then he was gone a month and a half later, but he had accepted the Lord. What's truly amazing about that is not just his conversion, but had affected his entire family even after he was gone. Relationships were restored, brothers and sisters, family members went back to church. It was quite an inspiration for us at the time in the program. And I remember there were only three of us on the stage. We were remembering him. And this year, when I look around at all the brothers and sisters that have come in the program, it's just an amazing feeling of what one little year has done in multiplying the Lord's work. When I came in there, I was pretty misdirected. And the whole process is one of patience, one of love. You know, I have like little, what we call character defects. You know, I have a tendency to talk too much, as you might see, ramble on, different things like that. And there was a lot of patience shown, a lot of love shown me. And through that example and through that love, I was able to become in a place where now I recognize those things that I saw about myself and others, and I'm able to show them love and patience and tolerance. The pastors that we work with, especially Gary, and there's Pastor Paul and Pastor Ray Lauder and Pastor Art Brown, they come and do Bible studies and teach. They have quite a testimony of the Lord. So when you're around them, you get a sense of the presence of the Lord, and at least I have. And that in and of itself is transforming. So by having a place where you take out all the worldly concerns and you're able to focus on those studies and on that spirit, you can't help but be drawn in and feel the love and be transformed. At least that's what it was for me. I'm completely enamored with this program. I think it's something that's needed all over the world, basically. God is alive and has love in that house, and the leadership, all the board of directors, the pastors, everybody that guides from love, God's love. And it's amazing to be in the atmosphere in the house where you feel the Spirit coming in and touching everybody in the house.